Welcome to this lecture about zero-inflated Poisson regression. When count data has an excess of zeros, that is called zero-inflation. Zero-inflation in the dataset might happen if our sample includes a subgroup which can only have a count of zero. For example, if you have data of the number of hours people watch TV per day, it may involve zeros for people who would not watch TV that often, but also zeros for people who don't have a TV. Zeros from people who do not have a TV will cause an inflation of zeros that cannot be explained by the Poisson distribution. These types of zeros are called structural zeros. Let's have a look at an example where we have counted the number of metastatic lymph nodes in 300 cancer patients. The green bars represent the number of patients with a certain number of metastatic lymph nodes. For example, this bar shows that about 4 patients have no metastatic lymph nodes, whereas this bar shows that about 15 patients have 1 metastatic lymph node. And this bar shows that about 25 patients have 2 metastatic lymph nodes, and so forth. The mean of the total number of metastatic lymph nodes is 5 in this example. Given a mean of 5, we can calculate the expected count according to the Poisson distribution. If we set lambda to 5 and k to 0, we see that the probability of observing no metastatic lymph nodes if the mean is 5 is 0.67%. If you multiply this probability by 300, which is our sample size, we see that we expect to observe about 2 patients with no metastatic lymph nodes out of the 300 patients. Let's mark the expected count with a red circle. If we now change k to 1, we see that the probability of observing 1 metastatic lymph node, if the mean is 5, is about 3.37%. If you multiply this probability by 300, we see that we expect to observe about 10 patients with 1 metastatic lymph node out of the 300 patients. We mark the expected count with a red circle. If we continue like this, we can compare the observed counts with expected counts. We see that the observed and expected counts are very close. This dataset shows a similar distribution of the counts as in our previous example, but we will now have an inflation of zeros. Since there are more zeros in this dataset, the distribution of the expected counts have now moved a bit to the left since the average count has been reduced. Since the observed number of zeros is much higher than what is expected, according to the Poisson distribution, this is a typical case of zero-inflation. According to the Poisson distribution, we expect to have about 3 to 4 patients with no metastatic lymph nodes. However, in our sample, we observe 43 patients with no metastatic lymph nodes. In total, we have about 40 extra zeros in addition to what is expected from a Poisson distribution. These extra zeros might be a result of structural zeros from a subgroup in the dataset. The inflation in zeros in this example might be due to many reasons. For example, there could be 2 groups of patients, one group with invasive tumors and one group with non-invasive tumors. To deal with zero-inflation, a number of zero-inflated models have been developed. Zero-inflated Poisson regression can be used if you have only zero-inflation, whereas a zero-inflated negative binomial model can be used if you have both zero-inflation and overdispersion. In this lecture, we'll have a closer look at the zero-inflated Poisson model. Let's say that we have the following zero-inflated data. We fit the Poisson regression model, including only an intercept, which estimates the mean of the counts. The estimated value of the intercept is 1.485. And e to the power of 1.485 is about 4.415, which is the estimated mean of the counts. Let's put a red line at 4.415 to show the mean in this distribution. Based on a mean of 4.415, we can calculate the expected counts according to a Poisson distribution. The expected counts are illustrated by the red circles in this plot. Since the inflation of zeros reduces the mean, and that a lot of the observations are structural zeros, the data does not fit well with the Poisson distribution. In contrast, a zero-inflated Poisson model fits much better to the data. We see that the green bars are now much closer to the red circles. The zero-inflated model separates the model into two parts. One part that is based on the Poisson distribution without structural zeros, and one part that predicts the amount of structural zeros. In this example, the structural zeros may come from a subgroup of patients with non-invasive tumors. Note that the mean has increased from 4.4 to about 5, since the structural zeros are no longer affecting its estimate. The zero part of the model fits the intercept to -1.986. E to the power of -1.986 is about 0.137, which can be interpreted as the odds of belonging to the zero group. Patients that are classified as structural zeros represent about 12% of all the 340 patients in the dataset. Here is another example of zero-inflated data. Out of the 1,000 observations, it seems like we have about 300 structural zeros. If we fit the zero-inflated Poisson model to the data, we see that the odds are about 0.43. Based on the odds, we can calculate the probability that an observation belongs to the zero group. We see that the probability that a patient belongs to the zero group is about 30%. The estimated proportion of structural zeros is therefore about 30%. This seems reasonable since we have about 300 structural zeros. We will here illustrate the importance of using zero-inflated models when we compare two groups with different proportions of structural zeros. In this study, one wants to test if a new cancer treatment reduces the number of metastatic lymph nodes compared to the old treatment. This table shows the observed number of metastatic lymph nodes for the patients on the old and the new treatment. For example, this number tells us that only one patient on the old treatment has two metastatic lymph nodes, whereas this number tells us that 9 patients on the new treatment have 2 metastatic lymph nodes. The average number of metastatic lymph nodes is about the same for the two treatments. However, if we neglect the zeros and calculate the mean based on the non-zero counts, we see that the patients on the new treatment have about 2 metastatic lymph nodes fewer than the ones on the old treatment. The reason for this difference is due to that a lot more patients on the old treatment have no metastatic lymph nodes compared to the patients on the new treatment. The reason for this difference could be due to a lot of things. For example, the ones on the old treatment may include more patients at lower risk for metastatic tumors compared to the ones on the new treatment. It is also possible that the old treatment actually completely prevents metastasis more frequently, which might be the reason why there are more zeros in the group of patients on the old treatment. Since there seems to be a difference in the proportion of structural zeros between the two treatment groups, a zero-inflated model can be used to account for this difference. If we use the Poisson regression model, no significant difference in average number of metastatic lymph nodes would be detected between the old and the new treatment. However, if we use the zero-inflated Poisson model, we will get very different results. Note, this result was generated by the PSEL package in software R. The old treatment is set as our baseline in this example. we see that the estimated mean of metastatic tumors for the ones on the old treatment is about 6.6. In comparison to the Poisson regression model, the zero-inflated model shows that there is a significant difference between the two treatments. The number of metastatic lymph nodes decreases by a factor of 0.731 for the ones on the new treatment compared to the ones on the old treatment. The average count of metastatic lymph nodes in the patients on the new treatment, if you neglect the structured zeros, is therefore 6.6 times 0.73, which is about 4.8. The ones on the old treatment, our baseline, have an odds of 0.66 to belong to the zero group, which corresponds to about 40% of the patients. The last coefficient shows that the odds of belonging to the zero group for the ones on the new treatment is about 0.4 times the odds for the ones on the old treatment. The odds that the patients on the new treatment belong to the zero group is therefore 0.664 times 0.409, which is about 0.27. An odds of 0.27 correspond to a proportion of about 21%. The estimated proportions of the patients belonging to the zero group, which is 40% and 21%, seems reasonable if we look at the data. This simple example shows the importance of using a zero-inflated model when analyzing count data with zero-inflation. This was the end of this lecture about zero-inflated Poisson regression. Thanks for watching.